doing very good with everything. I'm gonna do a quick down on the side over here. Down. Good. Another one. Down. Good. Okay, so she has been learning very, very quickly, and we have pretty much graduated from prom to e-collar. She is such a sweet girl, and she's already providing me so much eye contact. You are so sweet. Okay, so for place, we're gonna introduce it with e-collar and leash guidance. So I'm gonna approach it. You pause. Good girl. All right, place. Good girl. Set on her own. Good. Good. Yeah, that's Riley's hair. Let me see if I can get her to. Good. So just there, she stood up for a second, and I wanted to just use e-collar to give her the idea that pressure will go away when you go back into a down. And that's gonna start to build the expectation that whenever she's on the cup, this is the position I'd like for her to be in. Break. Good girl. Just giving her the practice that if I'm walking around her and she gets up, she feels stim, and then stim is released and she goes back into a down, just so she's starting to get the picture that, oh, she can walk around the cot, but no matter what position she is in, I should just stay in my down. Doesn't matter. Good girl. Good job. wearing her first earring. So basically what just happened there is I want to also build the habit of if a cat comes by, maybe make some sort of sudden movements. She can glance for a second because it's natural for us to be like, oh, what was that? But after she knows what it is, I don't want her to continue staring, because if she keeps staring, she's gonna fixate to the point where perhaps she might get off the cot or she might stand up. It's just, it starts to, how do I explain it? Just like, it's like a cycle and you wanna break the cycle. So breaking the cycle is tapping momentary on the e-collar. Every single time I need to do it consecutively, I bump up the number by quite a bit because I don't wanna nag at her. If you only go up by 2 every time to tap at her for staring at the cat, it's gonna take a while. But the thing is, you wanna make it so that she needs to take the e-collar tap seriously, right? So if she does not listen the first time, you really want to make the point get across from the next one. And then if the next one doesn't, then you bump it up even more, and then she's gonna go, oh, okay. And then in the future, hopefully you will only just need one tap.